about Brandon Ingram, what happened on that last play?
I think he's fine. We'll have to reevaluate in the morning. I think it was just a cramp, but obviously he had played a ton of minutes, probably a little dehydrated, so we're just playing it safe with him. He had a great game, loved his leadership out there, loved what he did for us, and he wanted to be in, but you know, we're playing a little bit safe with him right now. Well, he was walking over to the bench, and like I think he was going to be able to, he wanted to go. Brandon wanted to play, and then I didn't see Magic do that, but like five of my assistants did. So they made sure that I knew, and that was fine. I mean, we need to protect him. But again, I was really proud of how he competed.
You said you were expecting to hear from him about how many minutes, like limitations for Brandon and some others. Did you have an idea of what that's
going to be? Not necessarily. No one's really given me any minute restrictions, but we're just playing guys and keeping an eye on them, and we need our young guys to play. We need to get them out there so they can compete and get better. That's how they're going to get better. We don't want to put anyone in danger or anything by too many minutes, but we have guys tracking that for sure.
Hey, John, what did you make of Lonzo's night overall?
It was a tough night for him. You know, I'm pretty sure he's disappointed. He has not played a lot of full court basketball since that last NCAA game. You know, we're not going to use that as an excuse. He needs to get better, but this was a hell of an atmosphere here tonight for his first game. I know he'll, you know, be better tomorrow night. That's for sure.
You got it.
What's that?
What were the positives you saw?
His passing is incredible. I mean, in that first half, you can really see what he can do. When he gets the ball in his hands, if you're running the wing, you better be paying attention or he's going to hit you in the side of the head. He can pass the ball. He can run the offense. Tough night shooting, and I know he's disappointed about that.
You guys told him to do that, or is that just him naturally pushing it that fast?
That's his game. That's why he was probably the number two draft pick, right? I mean, he's just that good with the basketball in his hands.
You played long enough, obviously, where you know shooting-wise, at least originally, do you think they'll step off him and say, you better prove it?
I'm sure they will. They did that a little bit in the second half, but he ended up hitting one. He'll be fine. You know, it's just there was a lot going on in here tonight, and we're confident he'll be better.
Thomas Bryant was a guy that seemed to just play with all of his heart tonight. What did you see from him that maybe people don't know?
Yeah, I loved TB tonight. His effort was awesome. He was the one guy that just really gave us energy. We had this lull in the second half. The start of the second half, it's just the focus was a little bit off for us. We had some breakdowns offensively. Defensively, we weren't very good, and we got him in the game, and he made a difference for us. That was obvious.
Calling more actions for Ingram, or did the ball just kind of find him as he got going there?
A little bit of both. You know, I think the guys on the team realized that we need, you know, he needs to have the ball in his hands for us to have a lot of success out here. But, you know, there's also some specific plays designed for him.
Yeah. You guys have seen his progress in the facility and seen how hard he's worked. Is it nice to see him feel great out there?
Yeah, he's one of the greatest kids, first of all. He's a high character guy. He's worked so hard this summer on his jump shot and just being in the gym and physically in the weight room, and I thought he looked great. I really did. He had some incredible plays out there, and also his leadership, like I talked about a couple of days ago, was just superb.
There were a couple times where I heard him, just whether it was getting on Zubats for defensive laps, whatever that was. Is that the vocal leadership thing you're talking about?
Absolutely. Yeah, I think he realizes it's, you know, this is his team out here this summer. And I think I'm hoping that's going to transfer into our team. I think he's ready for that next step of leadership. You know, leadership is a lot of different things. It's you know, guys have to respect you about your work ethic. I think he has that. And then you also have to get on the court and earn that respect on the court. He's done both in my mind. I think he's ready for the next step.
How do you feel mentally just going through the shooting night?
Fine. You know, I you can see there's frustration. You know, it was his debut. You know, he would have liked to have shot the ball better. I'm sure he'll look back in 5 years from now and laugh at tonight. But, you know, you can see just physically he was disappointed that he wasn't making shots.